Alright, greetings. This is the Crunchy Fit, and this will be a new What If. Now, I'm still waiting for the votes to come in for the Link Deku What If, female Link Deku. So, I'll be doing this in the meantime while the votes are coming in, and this will be What If female Deku was Cell. So, this is how she will look. In this, for this what if, and she'll basically have all Cell's abilities, so his regeneration, and his all of the moves that he has copied. So the Kamehameha, all that jazz. So we shall begin now. The characters in Dragon Ball Z do exist, but they are pro heroes and their abilities are their quirks. So, let's go. So, we begin with, now, I'm gonna sort of be taking some plot elements I saw in Ravenclaw, in one of Ravenclaw's What Ifs, so if you want. So, yeah. This isn't technically plagiarizing, it's just taking bits out of it. If I was plagiarizing, I would have copied the entire thing. Anyway, continuing. So we begin with David Shield. Yeah, David Shield. Now, knowing that All Might's time as the symbol of peace will come to an end eventually, he essentially sets up a meeting with the scientists on Ai Island and some of the pro heroes and governments from the world. As David Shield states that All Might won't be the number one hero forever. Eventually he will end up retiring or being killed, and the crime rate in Japan will go back up. So I have a proposal, as he would pull down some blueprints. Eddie'd state that he plans on creating a biological android to basically take All Might's place once his time as a symbol of peace is over. Downside is that in order for them to be the strongest, they'll need DNA samples from all the pro heroes, the strongest pro heroes across the planet. As the governments from across the world would call in the hero group, the Z Fighters, as all the members of the Z Fighters would come in, Goku, Vegeta, Gohan, all that, except for Yamcha. Why? Because you know why. If you've seen Dragon Ball, you know why. As David then explains his idea. As Vegeta, it sort of has the same personality as he did in the anime, so he is still quite arrogant, thinking that this project will never match up to the number to becoming strong enough to be the number one hero. As Goku would say, "Don't be such a downer, Vegeta. Besides, this could be a once this is done, they could be a really strong opponent we could fight one day." As Vegeta would say, "You're an idiot, Kakarot." As now, you're wondering, Kakarot is his real name, but Goku is his hero name. So, with that out of the way, the Z Fighters would give bits of their DNA to David Shield, as he would then begin his project. I'd say Melissa is about 15 at the time, so everybody else in UA would be around 13. And now UA will be a college in this one. So Melissa is currently helping David with his project. As over a couple of years, the cells would eventually begin to combine and multiply into the bioandroid, as the scientists on Eye Island would come about to oversee David Shields' project. As some of these scientists that are in there are actually sort of like spies for the military, because if they can steal her away, this project away, then they could be used as a weapon of war, which David doesn't want, so he basically checks everybody to make sure that they are not a member of the military. And anybody who is found to be a member of the military was immediately removed from the island at once. As a couple of years go by, as Izum, the android, which David had named Kiyomi. Yes, her name will be Kiyomi in this one. As he would basically be watching over Kiyomi, checking the vitals and all that. As David would note something odd. Now, in the original blueprints, they were basically supposed to look like cell, but they ended up looking like this, as you see in the picture, in the tube. With David being confused by this, and realizing that this is technically a cloning process, and it isn't 100% perfect, there possibly will be a sex change from male to female. As David doesn't really care that if they are male or female, he just wants them to become the number one hero. A couple years later, Kiyomi would have been fully developed. As this is about 2 years before UA begins, so everybody's about 16. All the Class 1A is about 16 right now. As David Shield would then open up the tube, test tube, as Kiyomi would fall out of the tube, landing on her feet. As she would begin to stand up, as she would ask David, "Who are you? And who are you? And where am I?" As David would say, "Well, I'm David Shield, and you are currently on Eye Island." As Izumi would then ask, "Who am I?" As David would say, "Your name is Kiyomi, her name is Kiyomi." As David would say, "Now come on, it's time that we get out of here before the scientists show up." As Kiyomi would then say, "Okay." Now, due to her just coming out of the test tube, she physically looks 18, but she is mentally a child because, you know, she's just been born. As she would... Hold on, give me a second. Sorry about that. As David would basically begin to take her back to a house he has on Eye Island, as he'd basically teach Kiyomi everything he knows, and Melissa would also help out in this, as Melissa and Kiyomi would develop a bond that was quite similar to a friendship, as Kiyomi would basically hang out with Melissa and help her with her projects, with one of them being a energy generator that she needed help with Kiyomi, thinking for a bit, as she'd get an idea, as she'd generate a key orb, which she would then put into the energy generator, which would give it power to generate a large amount of energy. Now, I'll say that the amount of energy produced would be able to power the... would be able to power... give me a second. I'll say it's enough power to supply the Eurasian continent for about 3 years. So it'll constantly have to be resupplied for about 3 years. Every time, that's how much power it generates. As Melissa would thank Kiyomi by hugging her, as Kiyomi would hug her back, just happy that she was able to help a friend. As Izumi is basically looking over David's notes on herself, as she would find a note that would say that she could reproduce asexually or with a partner. So, yeah, if you want guys want to have a ship, then you can. I'm just here to tell the story. I don't decide these things. Anyways, so Izumi finds that very interesting. But as she would put it to the side for a bit, for later, as she would continue looking over her notes, basically explaining her capabilities, her strengths and weaknesses, all that. Now, due to the Vegeta cells that she has, she is a tad bit arrogant. Only a tad bit, not too much. She would have little moments where she feels like she's superior to everybody else, but she's mostly kind and all that. As All Might would visit from time to time, as one time he would encounter Kiyomi, basically wandering around the halls, as he would ask David, "Who is this mysterious woman who is walking around your house?" As David would say, that's the project. That's Kiyomi. She was the project I was talking about for if you ever retire. As All Might would say, "Ah, young Kiyomi. So have you ever considered that she might join a hero school in order to learn about being a hero? Because I'm sure that if she immediately goes into hero work without knowing anything about being a hero, then it would just be sheer chaos if she doesn't know how to control her abilities." As David would say, "You're absolutely right." As David would say, "Hey, All Might, the entrance exam to UA is coming up in 2 years. So I'd like to ask you a favor, friend to a friend. Could you please train Kiyomi? Because she is strong, but she can't control her strength. She's having trouble controlling the large amount of power that's in her body. And I please ask of you to help her with this." As All Might would say, "Okay, David, as your friend, I shall help train young Kiyomi into becoming the best hero possible." As All Might would then walk up to Kiyomi, and as he would say, "Young Kiyomi, how would you like to be trained by the number one? How would you like feel if you were to be trained by the number one hero, All Might?" As Kiyomi would say, "Well, I would feel honored if you would train me. So Kiyomi's personality is basically like a little bit of arrogance, but she is mostly kind and caring, and she sort of like has a mix of David and Melissa's personalities, because she is very interested in science and all that. So she would, in her free time, she would basically be looking over notes about herself that David had created when he first started the project and went along with progress. As for the next 2 years, All Might would be training Kiyomi to become the next number one hero. As Kiyomi would eventually learn to control her power, with All Might one time, they had to train on some abandoned islands. With one time, Kiyomi and All Might basically destroying an entire island due to the intensity of their training. As Kiyomi would have felt super guilty about it, and would have flown off and grabbed a very large mountain. And I'll say it's one of the mountains from the Alps. It's not Everest, but it's one of them. As she would basically construct a new island from it and bringing up sand from the sea floor and plant some plant life from the other islands. As she would have basically reconstructed the entire island and its ecosystem perfectly. As All Might would bring this up with David's shield, as David would say, well, she was designed, as he would say, well, Kiyomi was designed to be the perfect being, so it makes sense if he had a photographic memory of what certain areas would look like, so that she could be better at her hero work. As All Might would say, well, David, you have appeared to have outdone yourself in your work. You truly are one of the world's greatest scientists, my old friend. As Kiyomi would overhear this, as she would actually begin to smile, knowing that All Might and David are both very proud of her progress. As, you know, I'm going to leave it right. No, not, I'm not going to leave it. As Kiyomi continues with her training, as David's shield would eventually notify Goku of Kiyomi's existence, as he would ask him if he could train her, because Kiyomi is basically out-leveling All Might in all the categories, speed, strength, and all that. As Goku would say, okay, I'll be right there. As he would fly over to the island that Kiyomi trains on. As Goku would land, as he would say, hi, I'm Son Goku, and I am here to help train you. As Izumi would feel honored to be trained by Son Goku, as Goku would have powered up to Super Saiyan, as Goku would have said, I want you to go all out, so don't hold back on me. As Kiyomi would say, okay, if you wish so. As Kiyomi would begin to power up, as a golden aura would begin to surround her. As Goku would think to himself, wow, she really does have all of ourselves. I wonder how powerful she is. As Goku's thinking to himself about this, the match had already started as Kiyomi would fly towards Goku and punch him in the face, sending Goku flying backwards into a rocky side of the island. As Goku would immediately get back up, as he would say, wow, you're really good. But that was a lucky shot. Let's go. As their fight would sort of go similarly to how the fight did in the Cell Saga, with Kiyomi and Goku matching each other on their respective levels. As we finally get to the instant transmission Kamehameha scene, as Goku would have blown Izumi's upper half off, to where David Shield is basically horrified that Goku killed his project, until Kiyomi's lower body would eventually like jump back up onto its legs, as Kiyomi's entire upper body would have regenerated, as Kiyomi basically go her head down, as she said, would say, "That was so cool! What was that? What was that, Goku, sir?" As Goku would immediately power down as he'd begin to scratch his head, as he'd say, Oh, that's just a little technique I had developed. It's called the instant transmission Kamehameha. As Kiyomi would say, "That's so cool. Can you teach me it?" As Goku would say, "Well, if you can perform my two moves, the Kamehameha and the instant transmission, then you can probably perform that." As Kiyomi would say, "Okay, Mr. Goku. As Kiyomi would have immediately gone off and tried to practice the Kamehameha, with her basically getting the position down, with her basically getting the position wrong each time, and Goku basically instructing her how to do it, sort of like how somebody, basically sort of like if you're a cook, when, basically picture it like when you're younger and you went to drive about in your parents' car, and you thought that you were driving the car, but your parents were actually like holding your hands to make it, to show you how the wheel steers. Basically picture it like that." As Goku would eventually get the position down with Kiyomi, as she would then begin to practice putting energy into it. And first time, only a little bit of energy came out. So only like a little short blue beam would come out, as it would have quickly dissipated as soon as it exited her hand. Second one would have got a bit further, but eventually it got to the end of the day and Goku and David had to call it a day, with Kiyomi headed home with David to begin more training. No, to get some rest because she needed it. As Kiyomi has her own room, as the walls are decorated with some hero memorabilia and some of David's scientific notes on devices that he's created and on herself. As while she's falling asleep, she's basically memorizing the position and the position of the Kamehameha and the energy, as she's calculating the math in her head of how much energy she has to put into it to result in a large amount of power and a large amount of distance. With Kiyomi doing that, as she would eventually fall asleep. Now, Kiyomi's height is sort of like Cell's in the original anime, so she's about the same height as Cell, which I believe was 6'3", I believe. Hold on, let me check. So she's about 7 feet tall. So David had to get a custom bed made for her to accommodate her height. As the next day would come about, as Kiyomi would have continued to do the math in her head as she would make it to the island, with Goku already being there, as he would say, "Let's try and do the Kamehameha again." As Kiyomi would say, "Yes, sir." As Kiyomi would get into the position, as she would begin to push the energy into her hands. As she would then let her hand out, as a massive beam would come out of it. It's basically about the size of Gohan's, it's about the size of Cell's perfect Kamehameha that he used against Gohan in the final battle. As it would then basically shoot off into space. As the ocean was basically split from the pressure of the Kamehameha. As the ocean would then come back together as the Kamehameha dissipated. As Kiyomi would have looked back to David and Goku, as she would have asked, was that a bit too much? As Goku would say, no, that's actually quite impressive. I wasn't even capable of doing that till I was 18. As Kiyomi is quite happy with the result of her training. As over the next year, Goku would have taught her how to do the instant transmission. As Kiyomi would have tried it and not be able to do it, and then eventually accidentally ended up teleporting off the planet to a different one, which Goku had to go fetch her for. And she would have accidentally ended up teleporting in on Melissa one time. As Melissa would have jumped up and said, What are you doing in here? As Kiyomi would have looked up as Melissa. Now, Melissa's 18 at this point. Since, you know, Melissa's older than Kiyomi at this point. As Kiyomi would have been. Melissa is basically in her underwear right now. As Kiyomi would have immediately covered her eyes, as she would have said, I am very sorry. I was practicing with Mr. Shield and Mr. Goku, and I accidentally teleported here while trying to learn one of his techniques. As she would then put her two fingers back up to her forehead, as she would say, well, see ya, as she would have then teleported out. As she would have eventually teleported back to David and Goku, as Kiyomi would basically have a red face. As David and Goku would see this, and they'd ask her, what happened? As Kiyomi would say, I really don't want to talk about it. And that is where I'm going to end this part off. I do hope you guys enjoy it, and I will see you all next time. Ta-ta!